Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can make a basic table in HTML. Let's get into it. I guess tables are used to display a table of information. It's useful if you need to organize some information in rows and columns. So before we begin, what I think we'll do for a project is we'll create a table of personal finances. So before we create that table, let's create a heading. Perhaps an H2 heading, because I think that's a nice size, and then let's close this. So we'll make a title such as Personal Finances. And if you're a baller, you can write like a dollar sign underscore dollar sign like you're seeing money. Otherwise, if you're broke like me, you can put a frowny face. The first step to creating a table is that we need a pair of table tags. So we'll make an opening table tag and a closing table tag. Everything related to our table is going to be between these two tags. The second step is that we'll want to create our first row, and we can use the TR tag, and that is short for table row, and you'll want to be sure to have a closing tag for this as well. Anything between these two tags will be included with the first table row, and we'll make a couple table rows, but let's begin with the first. If we want to have a heading for the first cell in your table, use the table heading tag. Otherwise, if you don't want this to be a heading, you can use the TD tag for table data. But let's say that for the first row, we want these all to be headings. We'll use the TH tag for table heading, and I'll show you the difference between each of these two tags. So what I think I'll do for the first cell in the first row of our table is that I will put the word month here. And then we need a closing TH tag. Let's save this, reload the page, and it says month. So we can add a few different cells within here. So let's create another table heading tag. And perhaps I will say January. Then let's close this, save this, reload, and it says January right next to month. So let's do this for a few months. So let's do February. TH, March, perhaps one more, April. All right, let's save this, reload. All right, and this is the first row in our table. Let's say that we want to add a second row. Well, we need to use the TR tags, a pair of them. And you'll want to be sure that you're adding this second pair of TR tags outside of the first. So let's create another table row. All right, so what I think we'll do is that we will list perhaps income on the second row. So I'll create a table heading and I will list this as income, and then let's close this. Let's check this out. All right, so here is the first cell in our second row that says income. And let's add a few more cells just to populate everything after income for this row. So I'll just make up some numbers. So we don't want to use a heading, table heading. We can, but I don't think that's necessary for this part. So we can use the TD tag for table data. And I'll just make up an income. So how about we say $1,500. And then let's close this. And let's see what this looks like. All right, and here it says $1,500. Let's populate the second row with a few other incomes, and I'm just making up numbers here. You don't have to copy this. You can come up with your own numbers too, or even use your own personal finances if this helps. All right, so I'll just make up a number, 1,750. So we'll make another set of table data tags, and perhaps I will say 1,250. Then how about a low number for April? $500. All right, let's save this, refresh. All right, and here the rest of our row two is populated with data. This table is becoming more difficult to read, and one way to make it more readable is to add a border around this table and between each of these individual cells of this table. So one way that we can add a border is that within the opening table tag, we're going to type border, we'll use the border attribute, and we'll set this equal to any number you want for the width of your border. 2 is a decent amount. You can either put 2 or 2px4 2 pixels. And let's save this, reload, and each cell within our table is now surrounded with a border, so this is more neat and organized. Now, one thing to notice with table headings and table data is that anything that's using the table heading tag is actually bold and it's centered. And with these table data tags, any text that's between these two tags is not bold and it's aligned to the left. So you can use either table headings or table data tags freely depending on how you want your table arranged. I feel like having anything within our first row or our first column as table headings wouldn't be a bad example, but you can use table headings and table data tags freely based on whatever you want for your table. You're not required to have table headings first for each table row, but create these tables however you want. All right, so let's create another table row. How about another for expenses? So we need to create a table row by using a table row tag, and then make sure to close this. And let's create a table heading. And we will put the text expenses and then close this. Let's save this, reload just to check this out. All right, we have another row and the first cell in this row says expenses, but I'm going to add a colon here just to match the others. Okay, let's make up some expenses. We can use a table data tag to add some data to this, and I will make up some numbers, perhaps 500. Then for the next row, how about 1,000? We spent a lot of money for February, you know, Valentine's Day. All right, then table data. Then we realized we spent a lot of money, so we're not gonna spend as much this month. So perhaps 750. And then for the last month, we didn't make much money. So let's put a really low amount for expenses. We spent $150 this month. We were broke. All right, let's see what this looks like. Oh, I think I'll add a minus sign. All right, let's reload this. All right, here is our expenses for each of these months. Let's create another table row, perhaps one for savings. Like, what is our savings with income minus expenses? So let's create another table row. So we need to use the opening TR tag for table row and a closing one as well. Right now, we don't have any automatic ways of calculating what the sum of these two cells is, like it's an Excel spreadsheet. So I'm just going to do this by hand. So let's create a table heading and we will call this savings. And we will close this table heading. And let's create a table data cell. And 1,500 minus 500 is 1,000. I'm just going to do the same thing with each of these columns. So table data. And for February, we saved $750. And for March, I think that is 500. And lastly, for April, we did not save much. We saved $350. All right, let's see what our completed table looks like. All right, there is our last row, savings, and these are our savings for each of these months. This black and white table is boring. Let's add some color. I'll show you how to do that. So within each of these table rows, let's say we want to color the first row. So go to the opening tag for the table row. This is what we're going to type: BG color equals, and then pick a color. So pick whatever color you want. I think I will just say gray. Let's save this and refresh the page. All right, well, gray technically isn't a color, or is it? I don't know. But it's not white and black anymore, which is the point. Let's do the same thing with income. For the next opening tag of our next table row, we're going to type BG color, and you could pick a different color or the same one, doesn't matter. I think I will pick yellow, like it's gold or something. Let's save this, reload, and the second row in our table is now yellow. So let's do the same thing for expenses and savings. So BG color equals perhaps red, because we're subtracting money, it's negative. It's a bad sign. Then let's do the same thing for the last row. So BG color equals perhaps green. Save this, reload. Here is our artistic exhibit of our personal finances colorized circa the year 2020 or so. But you know what? We can take this a step further. Let's change the background color of our table. So within the opening table tag, what we'll type is BG color equals, and then we can give this a new background color, perhaps black. Let's save this, reload, and the background of our table is now black. We can also give the individual cells in our table a specified minimum width and height using the width and height attributes. So for our month table cell, it's going to be this one right here. Within the opening table head tag, we'll write height equals, and this is in pixels, perhaps 10. And then width, we can say equals 75. So let's see what this looks like. And you can see that the dimensions of the month table cell, as well as with the other cells that come after it, all change to match the width of 75 and the height of 75. And you know what? I'm going to apply this to the others as well, just so that each of these cells in our table is more uniform. So I'm going to paste this in each of these table heading tags. So now all the cells in our table should be uniform then. So that's kind of nice then if you want everything to be of the same size. You can also apply the height and width attributes to the table as a whole as well. So we'll put that within the opening tag of our table. So let's specify a minimum height for the table. We'll say perhaps 150. Let's save this, reload. And the entire table now has a minimum height of 150 pixels. Now you're not limited to just specifying the height and the width in pixels. You can also place a percentage here, and the percentage applies to the room available on the web page. So we could say width equals, you can place pixels here, otherwise you can place a percentage. Let's say that we want our width of our table to take up the entire web page, the entire width of the web page, that is. So we'll say width equals 100. Let's save, reload, and the width of the table now takes up the entire web page. And this is dynamic. If I were to change the dimensions of this web page, the table is also going to change dimensions as well. So the width will always take up 100% of the width of the web page. Lastly, for this topic on tables, and I promise that this is going to be the last one, there's an attribute called align, and you can align text in the space that's available to it. Let's say that we want to align some of these dollar amounts within our table. Let's start with income. So what we'll do is that we'll go to our table row opening tag, and we will use the align attribute. Now we can align text to the left, to the center, or to the right. But let's say that we want to align all of the text within this table row to the center. So we'll say align equals center, and then we will save this, reload the page, and all the dollar amounts within our income are center aligned now. So just to be consistent, I'm going to copy this and put this in the other table rows that we have. And voila, here is our completed table, and I would say that this is good enough for this beginner HTML tutorial. If you would like a copy of this HTML document, I'll copy all of this text and post it as a comment down below and pin it to the top. And if you're looking for additional practice or a project to work on, why don't you create your own table of your own personal finances? But yeah, that is everything you need to know to get started creating tables in HTML. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.